Hey guys, in today's video I'm going to show you how I highlight and contour using both cream and powder products. I love how contouring and highlighting enhances your features and brings depth to the face. This is not an everyday natural look, this is what I do if I'm going out at night or to a special event. Using both cream and powder products together ensures your makeup will stay on all day or all night and it won't budge. I'll be doing another video on a more natural everyday highlight and contour routine, so stay tuned for that video. I've already applied my base, so let's get started. First, I'm going to highlight. I'm applying a cream banana shade from the Anastasia Cream Contour Kit that is a few shades lighter than my skin tone on the areas I want to stand out and be lifted. I start by drawing triangle shapes under my eyes to brighten and lift. This will cover any dark circles and makes the eyes look more awake. Then I'm going down the bridge of the nose, center of the forehead, Cupid's bow and chin. This just adds more light to the center of the face to bring these features forward. I like to highlight around the mouth where you tend to get redness or discoloration. I then take this line and draw it up to connect to the bottom of the ear. This goes under where we're going to contour to give it a sharper finish. Moving on to contouring, I'm going to take this shade on the far bottom right from the Anastasia Contour Kit again, that is a few shades darker than my skin tone. Contouring makes features of your face recede to create a shadow and gives a more sculpted look to the face. I'm starting with the sides of my temples and across my forehead. This will slim the face and add more dimension. Then I'm going down the sides of my nose to give it a slimmer look. I'm contouring in the hollows of my cheeks. This makes your cheekbones look higher and more sculpted. I also like to contour around my chin and along the jawline to give a more oval shape to the face. This is the face shape you want to achieve when highlighting and contouring, as it gives a more balanced shape to the face. Now we can start blending this all out. First, I'm using a damp beauty blender to blend out the areas we highlighted. I like using beauty blenders for cream products because they just make the product melt into your skin and absorb any extra products so you don't look cakey. When you only apply foundation, your face can look flat and lack shape and definition. From working at a few different makeup companies, I found people would want to buy a darker shade of foundation because they thought their foundation looked too pale on their skin and they didn't use any bronzer to add more colour naturally. So what highlighting and contouring does is bring back colour and dimension back into the face. Since we all have different face shapes, you want to take this tutorial and mould it to your face shape. For instance, if you have a smaller forehead, you might want to focus more on highlighting than contouring on that area. Or if you have a rounder face, you will focus more on contouring around the sides of your face. I'm using a MAC 130 Duo Fiber Synthetic Brush to blend out the contoured areas. This type of brush is great to use for creams as it just blends the product out seamlessly and really buffs it into the skin without removing any of the products you have applied. Make sure when you are blending out the cheek contours that you blend upwards to lift the cheeks and not downwards, as this can drag the face down and look muddy. I'm blending out the nose contour to blur the edges and give a naturally contoured look to the nose. Now we want to set the cream products with powder so they don't move or crease. I'm using the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette and taking the banana colour called Lyric to set all the areas we highlighted. I'm using a Zoeva Luxe Highlight Brush to press the powder under the eyes. You want to press the powder onto the skin and not rub, otherwise you can start to move the cream products. Then I'm taking a contour powder, this one is Subconscious, and setting the contoured areas. I'm using the NARS Eater brush as this gives a really sharp defined contour. Once again, I'm making sure to blend the powder contour up onto the cheek and not downwards. I'm very lightly diffusing the edges of the nose contour with this powder as well. I'm going back in with that banana powder and powdering underneath the contour to sharpen it up a little more. Now moving on to adding colour on the cheeks, I'm sticking with cream products and applying MAC Ladyblush to the apples of my cheeks. I'm blending back up to my ear. If you have a rounder face, you want to apply it more towards the hairline and not on the centre of the cheeks. For a cheekbone highlight, I'm using a cream. This is the Gerard Cosmetics BB Illumination, which adds a beautiful shine to the high points of the cheeks, down the centre of the nose and the Cupid's bow. To set the blush, I'm using a powder blush. This is MAC Peaches. I love using peach blush colours. They are my favourite and they complement so many different makeup looks. For highlight, I'm using Estee Lauder Heatwave, which is my all-time favourite highlight. It gives the most radiant, glowing look to your skin. The last step is to seal everything in place. I'm using MAC Fix Plus and this brings out all the highlights on the skin beautifully. I hope you enjoyed this video and found this helpful for getting that Kim Kardashian contoured look. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you all in my next video.